Check one, check, check one. Take all the pics you care to. Sit back, relax, enjoy yourselves. Alrighty, guys. Let's go have some fun. What do you say?
Come fly with me. Let's fly away.
And away we go.
Some exotic food. There's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me.
And up, up, and away we go. I'd like to welcome you folks to Boulder City, Nevada. Boulder City is the town that was built for the construction workers of Hoover Dam. Now, upon its inception back in 1930, Boulder City quite literally was a government-owned and regulated town. So much so that during the construction of Hoover Dam, we literally had a perimeter, a fence, all the way around Boulder City, only 2 points of entry and exit. Those were guarded gates. The idea was to restrict the activity within the compound. At that time, during the dam's construction, Boulder City was treated quite similar to a prison compound. Alcohol, drugs, prostitution, and gambling were all forbidden. And to this day, Boulder City is the only town in Nevada that does not have legalized gaming. Over to the right, your first glimpse of Lake Mead. Lake Mead is the reservoir created by Hoover Dam. Hoover Dam will be the first highlight of our trip. We'll be there in about 2 minutes. And we'll beat the birds down to our... Initially, the dam will be on the left side of your craft. However, once we're in front of it, I'll make a turn so you folks from South Carolina behind me will get a fantastic view as well. Come fly with me. Let's fly away. And in just a moment, over to the left, you get a pretty sweet view of the Las Vegas Valley.
Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide.
As promised, off to left, Las Vegas.
I'll be holding you so near, you may hear angels cheer, cause we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely...
And back in front, Lake Mead. Lake Mead is one of the largest man-made reservoirs in the Northern Hemisphere. Now, as we make our way toward Hoover Dam, you'll see prior to the dam, our new bypass bridge. The bridge you will soon see is the second highest bridge in the United States. It stands 900 feet over the Colorado River. The bridge itself is a product of the attacks on 9/11. Following 9/11, traffic crossing Hoover Dam was deemed to leave the dam susceptible to attack, so a bridge was built to alleviate that potential threat. up ahead here, this next ridge line we'll be crossing over. Dallas up here, Indian Pass. Native American tribes used to position scouts along this ridge line right here to watch settlers that were migrating through the area. Not attempts to attack, but rather try to sell supplies for their journeys through the desert. Horses, clothing, food. The reason why they chose this location, well, it has a lot to do with the song I'm playing for you right now, but I will point out to you in just 1 minute why that is. Up ahead of us, folks, that distant horizon up there is the western boundary of the Grand Canyon. Now, just ahead of us here, we're about to fly over a dirt road. It comes from the right across in front of us and goes over to the left. Imagine 200 years ago, long lines of horses and covered wagons passing down there. This down here is a portion of what is known as the Mormon Trail. It is the route that the settlers of the Mormon faith took when expanding their religion from Utah down to Southern California. That's the reason why the Native tribes staked out this ridgeline. The stark rock down below us, coming over to the right side of the aircraft, is known as the lava flows. This is residual effects from the volcano we just passed by. Now, all the water you see over here to the left in Lake Mead, this used to be snow, way up in the Rocky Mountains. From where the Colorado River begins, in the heart of the Rockies, the river passes through five U.S. states as it makes its way down to the Sea of Cortez, traveling a total distance of 1,450 miles. Along that route, four dams have been constructed to create reservoirs. Lake Mead, this is the second of the four reservoirs. All this water down here, this has already passed through the Grand Canyon. Now, the lake itself serves as a water source for those of us who live in the Las Vegas Valley. However, a majority of the water throughout the entire Colorado River system goes down to California and Arizona for agricultural needs. Hoover Dam, I did welcome you into the state of Arizona. The boundary between the states of Arizona and Nevada follows the original channel of the Colorado River, which runs midway through Lake Mead here ahead of us. So as we cross this portion of Lake Mead ahead of us, we will re-enter the state of Nevada for a few minutes before crossing a second time and going back into Arizona. To the right, on the far side of the water, is another example of how much water has been lost at Lake Mead. You see that cliff over there, it's Castle Child, reflection of the water coming back toward us. That down there is called Temple Rock. Now, 40 years ago, when I was a kid growing up out here, Temple Rock down there was a sheer vertical wall that went straight down into the water. That foundation we see now, it's angled out, that was below the water line. So, as I was growing up, Temple Rock was a very popular spot for cliff jumping. Not something I'd recommend nowadays. Take a look down below us here at the desert floor, you'll notice that spotted effect that is created by one single species of plant life called the creosote bush. Creosote is a chemical in the past often used on wood to reduce insect infestation, most notably on railroad ties and telephone poles, but it's a poison that is emitted from the root system of those plants down there, which is the reason why there's nothing growing immediately next to them. and Kenya is home to 271 different species of birds, including the endangered California condor. We have golden eagles, bald eagles, peregrine falcons, turkey vultures. Quite likely we'll have a couple of ravens that land at our picnic site. They like to try to get some breakfast for you folks. If they do make an appearance, their names are Rotor and Jackie. 75 different species of mammals inhabit the park, ranging from bighorn sheep, wild mustang and burro. We have elk, bison, mountain lion, black bear, bobcat, and 47 different species of reptiles and amphibians call the Grand Canyon home.
Dreams that you dream of once in a love.
Over to the left, one final example of how much water has been lost at Lake Mead, because that down there, my friends, well, that used to be Lake Mead. Lake Mead used to extend all the way up to the very exit of the Grand Canyon.
Bluebirds fly.
It is my pleasure to welcome you to one of the seven natural wonders of the world. Thank you. Gentlemen, welcome to the Grand Canyon. How was it, guys? Not too painful? Alright, hang tight for a couple minutes while I get the aircraft shut down. Take a look around, folks. Lots of loose rock out here. Over the years, I've seen quite a few people slip and fall. It's pretty funny. I don't want to see it happen to you guys, though. So, walking around backward taking selfies out here is a pretty bad idea. We're going to head over to this first table. I'll break out your breakfast and your drinks. So, in addition to being a pilot and tour guide,